muted, so you guys won't hear the echo from my freaking heater. You're gonna hear the heater, but I apologize for that. It's really deep in snow right now. And just be glad at least the freaking snow trucks have stopped. So I can now start my stream. Now we go to Monster Cat. Let's see what we're gonna play. Let's try to uncage. Alright, man, thanks for showing up this early, man. That's a first. And of course, I had to go full Team TD today. Top of the Stewie tribe. Thank you. Yep, TD Tribe, bro. TD Tribe. Like I said, man, Acro's a bad influence. Now we're going full TD this morning. Thinking about it. Alright, man, appreciate you stopping by. Definitely appreciate it. Are you a streamer too? Appreciate it. Oh boy, my connection's starting to act crazy. You know, I think I'm already following you. Computer's acting super slow right now. There we go. Yeah, definitely appreciate you stopping by, and I had to give you a follow real quick. I apologize, my chat is like completely glitched out on my computer, so I had to refresh. Thank you. twist, being twisted a second ago. So Taylor, you shut the mouth for me now. As we're going to Team TD today, time to get some shout outs to people. Go ahead and give you guys the dirty on the other guys in the TD tribe, Mike and Acro the Great. And this will be my new theme song. Whoever Spotify must have got playing right now. Come through the hot golf on Peg for Norris. Okay. fans make a difference. TV Tribe, that. They're about 30 pounds each. I mean, combined, they're lower 15 pounds each. But you'll feel it once those chains go in there, they're only about 30 pounds at the bar, but it feels like an extra 50. I love to take note, upgrade the sound to Muscle Cat. So I finally worked on and got Muscle Cat license. Thank you.
Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, make sure you anchor down your jammer presser or your jammer cut. Your landmine good so you won't have your whole system tipping over like an amateur. Just saying. Jump press is coming up.
Doing good, sir. Doing good. Thanks for stopping by. I'm probably butchering your name, so I'll say. Yeah, I'm doing good. And please excuse the heat. Is angry stuff. Thank you. much easier way of doing dolphin push-ups by doing dolphin push-ups. Alright, man. You can press shoulders, bring them down so you don't snap your shoulders up while doing these jammer presses. You have to be careful if you got long arms like me. Even though you probably can't see this. So I'm not kind of recording myself to make sure I got the right angle. It shows like my form is good on this because it's one of those exercises where you want to make sure your form is good so you don't snap your shoulders up. That's what I'm showing you guys to replay off my phone. Hope it's not too janky, but yeah. Make sure your form is good and you don't need to go that heavy to really feel it. Shoulder joint up right afterwards, bro. Why your shoulder hurt? I'm like, dude, you went too heavy. Instead of pressing it like this, you're trying to do this crazy stuff. So, rule of thumb, like my man Seth the Rep said, form over heavyweight always. If your form is garbage, don't matter how much weight you have in the bar, you're not going to get any effects. In fact, you're in with ill effects. Or so they won't get any positive effect, they have ill effect as a result in the long term. Yeah, I'm about to do the phone for this one too. Same idea though. Nice doing one arm. that's doing real good on time. Same idea. Deep breath, shoulder, push up. Elbow close to your body at all times you're doing this movement.
You can
case anyone's interested. Kind of same idea with sing alarm, same concept. Just make sure you tuck your shoulders in, try to tuck your elbows in, decompress your shoulders, bring them down, instead of having them hiked up, and you should be fine.
Going to cave with my gym, so it turns like a giant transformer. Why are you putting this type of stuff on here? Because it works. Thank you. Let me catch up on chat.
Oh, do some decline work. So about to do the decline cable presses. This is provided by Monster Cat. Process.
says Bologna Os. Arbitrary pulse. Alright. There's an arbitrary notation.
Wade doing this unilaterally and then do flies. Jonathan Wade going unilateral and then I'm doing flies right after that. Hey, how you doing? Thanks for stopping by. Yeah, unicorn, my shirt's missing. I went full TD this morning. Sorry, coming. As soon as I was taking a sip, so I'm like, trying not to have it come squirt out my nose at the same time. How you doing this AM or PM where you're at? Probably PM. Probably hope I didn't say tangled up. There we go. Yeah. Echo the Great and Mike Fit have pretty much convinced me to join the TD Tribe. We're not a cult. TD Tribe is not a cult. Let me get that straight to everybody. It's not a cult. Echo's like to do weird sacrifice for some reason. Whatever. Alright, back to the training. Yep, the twist part out to me. Yep. Even though I'm not going to have any huge improvements on the last one, still participate for fun. That's my main reason. Here we go, Skull Crushers. There we go. Ain't nothing wrong with Russo, Father. Nothing wrong with that. Considering tomorrow's my day to sleep in, so understandable. So tomorrow's gonna be crazy. So tomorrow I'm gonna train probably like 1 or 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Then Sunday I gotta train early again, so probably around 6 a.m. And then on Sunday I'm also doing my 2 p.m. yoga class. And then after that, 5 a.m. until next week Saturday, and of course Saturday, it's gonna be early morning. But not 5 a.m. early, probably like 7 a.m. Alright, let's check out this last set.
Skull Crushes, I'll be honest with you, I don't even use that much weight on it. I
pretty much put like 25 pounds on each side of the bar. I think it's on like a 20-pound bar, so probably like 70, 75 pounds. Because I'm not one of those guys that put 100 pounds on a freaking skull crusher that want to know where their elbow snapped up. And true story, years ago, I know a guy that actually decided he was going to do skull crush with a 45-pounder on each side of the bar. The guy was strong, but here's the deal. He went down, and his elbow snapped right there in the gym. And he was out for about 2 months, so yeah, now that's what you want to ego lift and try to go super crazy heavy with. Alright, Lifting Unicorn, thanks for stopping by. Have fun with the kettlebells. Those things kill your shoulders and they kill the hammies, most of the hammies. But I always find it good for like shoulders when you're doing shoulder presses with them. Because it's the build as the ball. So basically, you also get a lot of form in there too. Notice up, I'm making a little Sunday, so I got to probably have like an extra half hour to put on a half hour morning I do during the weekday, so I may put it in there as a burnout. I will say with skull crushers, don't try to do anything with less than 5 reps. Because I think the reason the guy in the gym snapped his stuff up, he was trying to hit a 1 rep max on skull crushers. In other words, the guy was like going to that point where at 3 reps, his form was already doing this. So it was a matter of fact, so when he went to that 1 rep max, or what he thought was his 1 rep max, he came down and it was like, pop! And of course, a buddy of mine, I told him, drop the weight. I told him that his form was breaking down, like, dude, drop the weight before you tear your elbows up. I literally walk away, next thing you know, I heard something popping, the dude was screaming. So, lesson of the day. No point in ego lifting with overhead skull crushers, because you may in fact almost crush your skull. Fortunately, the bar hit him in the chest, but it was like one switch. We looked at him like, dude, what the hell are you thinking? He's fine now. It was like one switch. He's like literally, I mean, he didn't actually break. Fortunately, he didn't break his femur. Sorry, he didn't break his arm or anything, but he like literally like pulled a tendon like right here in his elbow joint. So it took him about 2 months for him to recover. So basically it wasn't so much him going heavy, it was more or less him being stupid and using garbage form and then trying to ego lift the weight up. So I would say when your form starts to break down, well, I mean I would say this. Whenever you get 5 reps, skip, but once your form starts breaking down on that 4th or 5th rep, stop. So I would say, so basically skull crush, anything you can get with clean 4 or 5 reps is good. People mess themselves up when they go down to 2 and 3 reps and start using garbage form. And now we're at Twisted, it's the same dude I trained with that actually got my deadlifts up. So he helped out on back then, I tried to help him on chest day. The only difference is I listened to him on like checking my form out on deadlifts. He didn't listen to me when I tried to tell him not to go freaking all out on skull crushers. Hopefully that's not too much of an anger rant, but lesson learned, that's how you lose a gym partner for 2 months. Tricep push down to base pulls. All right, Unicorn, thanks for stopping by. Catch you later. Uh-oh, spoke cheese on, so I'll run twist. I'm on my last exercise of the day, which is at cable app. So once I'm done with cables, we're going to raise Spochy. So guys, hold on for just a few more minutes. Strain. Go ahead and do this. No problem, old father, always. So guys, about to go ahead and give Spochy a decent raid. Hope I'm typing in the commands correctly. Alright. See you guys later. Peace, and appreciate you guys stopping by. Time to start this raid.